Hello. I got this email from Mr. Guillermo Rosafa Garcia. What a beautiful name. We ain't got names like that in the Netherlands. He is complimenting me with my Christmas cartoon video. Thank you very much, mister. Amazing cartoon. Love the movement and expression on your drawings. By the way, how do you set up your brush configs on Illustrator? So I guess Mr. Rosafa Garcia is asking about precious sensitive brushes, how to set them up. You see the normal brushes in Illustrator, like these, are not precious sensitive at all. When you press hard or soft, doesn't matter, the line is equally thick from the beginning to the end. So to make a pressure sensitive brush, you go here, you select new brush, calligraphic brush is alright, name it, Susie is always a good name for a brush. You can do something about the angle of the brush and the roundness, but we don't do that now because we're here for the pressure sensitive in this knee system, pressure sensitive stuff. So here at size we see fixed and we set it to pressure. And then we got this little box which says variation with a slider, and we slide it all the way to the right. Now you see over here the left dot is the size when you press soft, and the right dot is the size when you press hard on the pressure sensitive pen, which you of course need. Variation 9. Oh, slide it all the way up. Okay. I said okay. And here in the palette we got our new pressure sensitive brush, and it says Susie. So select black for a line, and then pressing very soft and hard and soft and hard. And we got a nice smooth line which varies in thickness. So that's all there is to it. That's how you make a pressure sensitive brush in Illustrator. There is only one quirky thing about Illustrator when you open a new document. So let's see what it does. We open a new document, all right, and your new brush has disappeared from the palette because Illustrator does not save it. Fortunately, you don't have to go in there here and do everything over and over. You just go to the document where you created your brush. You select the line that you made with it, copy it with Edit Copy or Control C, and paste it in your new document. Edit, paste, or Control V, and here we got Susie again, all ready for use in your new document. Even when you delete that line again, you can use the new brush. All right, I hope that was useful to you guys. Please let me know in the comments. Maybe you got more questions. Love to help you if I can. Goodbye and thanks for watching.